Hello and welcome to another week of the A-League Kickoff. I'm Tim Morgan, keeping the chair warm for Nick Butler, and alongside me is the Scorpion King, Archie Thompson. Archie, how are you going this week, and have you gone viral for us at all?
Oh, I wouldn't say that, mate. I've had a bit of a sore back for the last week, to be honest, and for some reason my son's not answering the calls. I call him and usually answers, but after that segment, I haven't been able to. And I'm a bit dirty on butts, to be honest, because... you know, he always, when I come in here, thinking I'm just going to have a nice little day on the couch, he's always got some scheme. And I'm just not rating him. So I'm really happy that you're here, mate.
Did you get any positive feedback at all?
No.
Nick Butler's not here. I thought we'd send him up to Queensland to investigate why these games had been called off for the floods. There seemed to be some people on Twitter that were questioning it. I don't know why. There's ovals that are underwater, but I sent Butts up. This is what we got for our investigative reporter, Nick Butler.
Hey, mate, we're on. Hey, g'day, Kickoff crew. Now, firstly, I'm not on a holiday. It was just the big dogs at Paramount Plus and 10 Arch thought it's not possible for us to sustain our recent level of performance. We've just been so funny. We're setting the agenda on issues. And they said, hey, big fella, you cannot keep this up for the entire A-League season. So they said, get in the Paramount budgies, the blue and whites, get your ugly stick in the water a couple of times and come back fresh for the final.
Oh, mate. Well, you know what? Could have probably been done a bit better on Nicky's part. Is maybe he could have put a sock in that in those jocks, to be honest, because the rig's great, but maybe just looked like it was lacking a bit in the sock department.
The feedback's been still less offensive than the kit you rolled in with last week. So,
oh well, look, this is what look.
I've you've actually, dressed up for us mate, today, which is well, which
yeah,
is very nice.
I've got the silks on. I'm feeling good. I thought Buttsy would be a bit. This is a better. This is much better. Thank you.
So Butts has said, keep off the funny stuff for me. So I'll get on to the serious issues with you. And let's start with the Socceroos. And
yes,
the big push from the media circle over the last few days has been Marcelo Bielsa, obviously parted ways with Leeds, and the idea that maybe he's the next man to lead the Socceroos. What are your thoughts on that sort of push?
Well, look, you can see what he did for Leeds last year, because they were probably one of the most exciting teams to watch in the Premier League. This year, unfortunately, the wheels fell off pretty much. Don't know why, but quality manager. And when you're throwing those names in the mix when it comes to a national team, it's exciting for fans, exciting for a country, because we're almost screaming that. But I still would like to see Arnie get up, qualify for the World Cup and go to a World Cup, which he's always wanted to do.
I was curious to ask, because I think we love these sort of stories in the A-League and Australian football about who could we get, who could we bring down. And did you remember in your time who created the most buzz, either by coming here or even just being linked to the A-League or to the, you know, the Australian football scene?
Yeah, probably myself. Like, you know, probably me. I would say Harry Kewell. I remember when Harry Kewell came to Melbourne Victory, it was like a rock star. He was a rock star because, you know, it used to be very quiet on Gosh's paddock when we used to train. All of a sudden, Harry Kewell comes and, you know, we've got every single media man and his dog coming to report.
Let's get on to the A-League action. And yes, it starts on Friday night. We mentioned the flooding up there in Queensland. So we haven't seen Victory in a while. They take on MacArthur Friday night.
Yeah.
We mentioned the hangover post the FFA Cup. They got back on track, but will the week off have done them the world of good heading into this
match? Oh, look, I hope so. I know that we've been talking about this hangover. It's almost like they've been drunk the whole time, to be honest. But I think now they've had a bit of a break. There was a lot of games getting thrown at them. And especially when you're not getting results, they always say that, you know, at least there's another quick turnaround where we can play. But when that result doesn't go your way either, it's almost like, OK, let's step back and have a bit of a break.
Who's your tip in this one?
Look, I think Victory, because, like I said, they've had a week off. I reckon they would have recovered well.
Let's get on to Saturday afternoon then. Western United against Newcastle. Western United sitting top of the table after 14 matches, yet it still feels they're sneaking under the radar. But should we start calling this team the favourites for the Premier's play?
You're right. They are sneaking under the radar, but, man, they're good. Like, they're so good. And, you know, they win games by the odd goal, but that just shows me the discipline that they have when they do go a goal up. And it's very hard for teams to break West United down. They've got good players everywhere, and there's a different culture, a different swag. I know that we have a joke about Johnny Aloisi and you know how he has this strut But I always say it's down to his knees because they're shocking. Like, if you see, he's got these bow legs and, you know, wear and tear, that's where you get that little pimp walk. But he has got a bit of swag now because his team is actually playing brilliant. And I have to say, if City don't get a result during the week, you'd have to almost put your money a little bit on the West United to go on, because at the moment I can't see any little kinks in the armour.
The other one Saturday afternoon, Central Coast against Brisbane Roar. And this, on paper, just looks like a game Central Coast need to win. They've gone seven matches without a win in the league, but they are better than that, aren't they?
Yeah, look, I just wonder when the cum dog's going to start firing. He's exactly what we need for football here in Australia. Someone a bit left of centre. And it won't be too long before he starts finding that form and the whole team starts finding the form, because, like you mentioned before this, is that they've conceded the last few minutes of the game.
Yeah, it just keeps happening late, doesn't it?
Like, and it happens. Like, it happens because once you start, you lose the one, it's OK. It's like, that's unlucky. Or you cop another goal from the next match, it's like, oh, man. Then if you say your third time, you're going, OK, that's when the legs start wobbling and around that sort of 90-minute mark. But I feel like once they get their first win, Brisbane haven't played too much football because of what's happening up in Queensland. So if it's a time for Central Coast to really take the 3 points, it's this game.
Saturday night, the big derby. Wanderers up against Sydney FC. Sydney creating a lot of chances, just not getting the result. Do they finally crack at this one against a Wanderers side that aren't showing too many different signs of life under Mark Redan?
Look, that's a tough one, because Sydney, I still look at their team and I still look at the players in that squad starting to come back, and they're great. Like, they're still so potent in front of goals. It's just conceding that silly goal when they are putting the pressure on teams. That's one thing that probably needs to be fixed for them. Western Sydney Wanderers, it's like, I don't understand why that team's not doing great. Like, they've got great players on paper, but it's just not working. So I think Derby, I'd love to see a massive crowd. I'll be covering that one, but I just feel like Sydney's got this one.
Let's go to Sunday afternoon, Wellington up against City. I feel like with the form City's in, you gravitate to them as the favourite, but you can't write Wellington off, can you? They just keep impressing.
Yeah, look, again, that's another team that I really love, because they've got that underdog tag, but City are starting to find form. They're winning games, but I still love Wellington.
Yeah, it looks like a ripping contest on paper. Sunday night, Perth up against Adelaide, and this is a great story in the sense that Perth finally, they get back home. What will that do for this group?
Hopefully we see better performances from Perth and a massive crowd, which I'm sure there will be.
Adelaide must be feeling unlucky in that sense, because they're going to catch this raucous Perth crowd and that wave of momentum, so they've got to ride that out, don't they?
Yeah, they do. But then as a player, you love that. You thrive on that. You want to upset your a team at home, especially when an atmosphere is like it is. And there's nothing better than that. I'm still getting a lot of stick from fans because I've done that everywhere in Australia, where you just go on, you know, take some of that. and it's great and I love it. So hopefully, Adelaide put on a great performance, but I still want to see Perth get a good result and keep those fans coming in.
Last one, I've got to ask you about Nestori Irukunda, the 16-year-old who's just scoring worldies for fun. Can you believe how he just seems to adapt to the level? Were you doing that at 16, Arch?
I don't know what I can say what I was doing at 16, mate, but it involved locking the bedroom door and playing some soft love music, and it'd just be me. But 16 years old, he's out there performing, scoring goals and important goals. He's won matches. So he's on the radar for, I think, a lot of big clubs in Europe. It's about him now keeping grounded, and that's having good people around him. But, mate, 16... And that's a superstar. That's a superstar.
Perfect. Arch, that wraps up a really big weekend.
There's probably a lot of stuff you're going to have to cut. I'm probably not going to be on the show next week, but hey.
You'll be here. If you come back, we'll certainly have it. I don't know about Butts. Not too sure whether they'll let him back in. There might be a warning about what he was wearing. But we'll see if he comes back from holiday. I'll certainly be happy to do it again. Arch, thank you for your time. Of course, if you want to keep up to date with all the A-League action this weekend, make sure you're tuning into Network 10 and Paramount+.